The State of the Union provides a unique opportunity for European civil society to get a sense of the Union's future direction. It is against that agenda that civil society can hold the Union accountable on behalf of its own citizens. The State of the Union should be a moment in which Europeans come together to talk about their present so as to plot a common future.
We've been moving from crisis to crisis. Citizens expect the European Union to address the big issues of our times, and they don't understand why it can't do so quickly and decisively. It's time to change that by involving active citizens and civil society and reshaping the Union into an institution that is value-based, democratic, easy to understand, and capable of addressing the issues that citizens really care about.
The last months have taught us how fragile health is. Today, more than ever, policymakers at any level of the European Union must consider health as a priority when setting a political agenda for the years to come. Health has to be before industrial and commercial interests. There is no social, economic, or financial growth without a healthy population.
In this turbulent period, citizens expect all public authorities to work in good cooperation. Local governments are a powerful means to handling crises and shaping a sustainable and resilient future. In light of this, EU programs will be key to their success. Now, it's time to work together for the recovery Europe needs.
2020, incredible year. We will always remember it. We are facing tremendous challenges, but we have seen also incredible steps which have been made in the past. Now we are looking forward to recovery, which is socially fair, which is green, which is sustainable. We are counting on the European Parliament, and we're counting also on workers' voices.
Since the beginning of this year, we have seen how vulnerable human life is. The pandemic has highlighted the importance of social interaction and made it clear that we need communities from the local to the European level where we support each other. As older people, we are more committed than ever to contribute to the further development of a Europe in which everyone has the chance to grow up and grow old in dignity and caring communities.
Au Restaurant du Cœur, bénévoles et personnes accueillies, bénéficiaires de l'aide alimentaire, des enfants majoritairement, se retrouvent chaque semaine dans une dignité partagée. L'aide alimentaire est en effet une porte d'entrée vers l'inclusion sociale. Chaque semaine, ils voient que le drapeau européen est celui d'un souci partagé de vivre en commun. Merci de ne pas l'oublier au moment du vote du budget du FEAD.
This pandemic situation highlighted more than ever just how important volunteers are to our society. CV calls for policymakers to increase their focus and investment in volunteer involving and volunteer infrastructure organizations that will reflect the importance and the commitment of volunteers for Europe.
Der Zustand der EU ist gut, er müsste aber noch besser sein. Die Zukunft Europas entscheidet sich aktuell. Bei bedrohter Rechtsstaatlichkeit, den Auswirkungen von Corona oder des Klimawandels. Wir sind vor allem die Mitgliedstaaten gefragt, eine noch handlungsfähigere EU als die Lösung zu schaffen.
We look forward to seeing education and training for all as part of the solution and recovery plan for the years to come. But we would welcome a more ambitious budget, as that can only be achieved with the help of civil society networks across Europe that play a key role in conveying citizens' voice.
Decades of progress on gender equality and reproductive freedom are under attack from macho bullies with no respect for EU values and zero care for women's lives. The EU must stand firm against this backlash on women's rights and prioritize the safety and well-being of women and girls.
We envision a strong, diverse and united Europe with empowered young people who all have safe and equal opportunities to be socially, economically, culturally and educationally mobile.
Our message is that young people and innovation are at the heart of the European political agenda for economic and social recovery in support of all member states.
Young farmers and food production, it's a heaven-made combination. Investing in them is investing in a future generation. A Europe where rural and urban communities go hand in hand. If provided with equal opportunities, stronger we will stand.
Da questa crisi sta nascendo una nuova consapevolezza. Nessuno si salva da solo. In tal senso, il Next Generation EU è la prova del 9 per l'Unione Europea, soprattutto per le giovani generazioni, perché non c'è alternativa all'Europa, non c'è alternativa al futuro.
Given the challenges posed by the coronavirus, and globally we see the threats posed to the values underpinning the European Union, at European Movement Ireland, we hope that this year's State of the Union address will focus on how the Union strives to become a union that works for all citizens, and through the Conference on the Future of Europe, listens to the voices of all Europeans.
Europe is at an historical turning point. We need the deep reform of Europe. We need it even more after the crisis. We need to prepare the reform with a stronger participation of civil society and a stronger participation of citizen movement, especially in the Conference of the Future of the Union. This is the commitment of the Union of European Federalists.
The past few months have been tough, but improving European democracy remains crucial. The reforms that President von der Leyen announced last summer need to be put back on track, such as transnational lists, improving the Spitzenkandidaten principle, and launching a meaningful, inclusive and non-tokenistic conference on the future of Europe.
Last month gave us many lessons for the future. In big cities or small villages all over Europe, we need democratic energies. The future must be different from the past. We have to build it together, in solidarity. We must ensure democracy and equality for all.
The COVID emergency has made it clear we cannot have a sustainable and inclusive future if we are not ready to build it together. Therefore, the Conference on the Future of Europe will probably be an excellent occasion to do it together and to include seriously inputs and insights from civil society and local governments.
The EU is faced with several crises at the same time. We have arrived at a defining crossroads. Representing progressive civil society in Europe, we as Solidar expect the EU to be bold as it chooses its path. To reimagine something greater, as it rebuilds towards a new and improved normal. One that offers sustainable development, social rights and democratic freedoms. One that caters for all.